is the Writer's Almanac for Sunday. It's the 13th of December, 2020. It's the birthday of the poet Kenneth Patchen, born Niles, Ohio, 1911, author of more than 40 books of poetry like Before the Brave and Hurrah for Anything, and novels including The Journal of Albion Moonlight. Kenneth Patchen, who said, "Think enough and you won't know anything." It's the birthday of the poet James Wright, Martins Ferry, Ohio, 1927. Went to Kenyon College on the GI Bill after World War II, studied writing formally. First book of poems, The Green Wall, in 1956, and then St. Judas 3 years later. Wright thought that he was finished, that he'd said everything he had to say, and then he met the poet Robert Bly and Bly's wife Carol, and they befriended him and took him with them on their Minnesota farm. James Wright said, "They loved me and they saved my life." It's the birthday of the music critic Lester Bangs, Escondido, California, 1948. Wrote for Rolling Stone, Cream, other magazines. Lester Bangs, who wrote, "The ultimate sin of any performer is contempt for the audience." And it's the birthday of Mary Todd, born Lexington, Kentucky, 1818, to a well-off family. She was petite, had sparkling blue eyes, reddish-brown hair, highly educated, interested in politics, moved to Springfield, Illinois, to live with her sister, and it was there that she met Abraham Lincoln. They were opposites in many ways, and she was also being courted by Lincoln's political rival, Stephen Douglas, who Mary Todd turned down. She and Lincoln had a stormy on-again, off-again courtship. They broke up and they got back together. In 1842, they married, moved into a boarding house where their first child was born. She suffered from depression, anxiety, paranoia, and migraines. Her time in the White House was not happy. After their son Willie died of typhoid fever, Mary Lincoln was crippled by grief. After her husband's assassination, her health declined. She was nearly destitute for a time, committed to an insane asylum, attempted suicide, and spent her last years at her sister Elizabeth's home in Springfield, rarely coming out of her room. Here's a poem for today by Stephen Dunn, Briefcases. 15 years ago, I found my father's in the family attic, so used the shoemaker had to repair it, and I kept it like love until it couldn't be kept anymore. Then my father-in-law died, and I got his, almost identical, just the wrong initials, embossed in gold. It's 40 years old, falling apart. Soon there'll be nothing that smells of father love and that difficulty of living with fathers. But I'd prefer a paper bag to those new briefcases made for men living fast forward, or those attaché cases that match your raincoat and spring open like a salute and a click of heels. I'm going to put an ad in the paper, wanted, old briefcase, accordion style. And I won't care whose father it belonged to, if it's brown and the divider keeps things on their proper side. Like an adoption, it's sure to feel natural before long. A son without a father, but with this one briefcase carrying a replica comfortably into the future. Something for an empty hand. Sentimental the way keeping is sentimental, for keepsake, with clarity and without tears. Briefcases, a poem by Stephen Dunn from his New and Selected Poems, 1974 to 1994. Published by W.W. Norton and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.